Greetings, fellow Wildlings. Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls to Daggerfall as a mage. We are in Elysian Hills, and we are in front of the Mage's Guild, as you guys can probably tell by this symbol here. It's a rainy, gloomy kind of day, and everything is totally dull and dark. Is it just me, or does Daggerfall Unity actually make things look darker than they're supposed to? I feel like it does. Anyhow, we are headed inside the Mage's Guild. This guy looks fancy. Mercenary mages. I'm guessing that's like the quester here. So yeah, we're heading inside the mage guild to find quests to complete. This mage guild actually looks quite fancy, really. I like the layout of this place. I really do. Alright, so with that being said, let us go ahead and talk to this guy. Let's see what kind of quests he has. Because you see, our reputation at the mage guild is quite low. Just 2. So we do need some kind of quest to, you know, bolster our reputation before we get kicked out of the guild. As soon as our rank goes into the negative, or I think it's 0, we get kicked out. So we want to avoid that. So yeah, might as well complete a few quests for them, whatever they might be. Yeah, right here. This guy actually looks quite fancy though, doesn't he? Looks like he's seeing something as well. Anyhow. By Pelagius. Is there anything more exasperating than the discovery that the mummy wrappings you were planning on using in a potion have called all sort of green? I could use the guild's wrappings, but the recipe specifically calls for superlatively fresh mummy wrappings. Whatever that means. I don't suppose you'd be willing to scare me up some cloth of a mummy I know has more wrapping than it knows what to do with. I like the way you put it. And yes, the mummy does indeed have more wrapping than it knows what to do with. So I should have probably saved before accepting this quest. But alright, let's go. Jolly good, apprentice. What is this, England? Jolly good. It'll be worth 183 gold to you. Now this mummy's tomb is not too far away at all. It shouldn't take you any longer than 7 days to get there. Make your grab and get back. Remember, it's got to be fresh. Preferably off its body. The name of the place is something like the Stronghold of Copperston. Why does that name sound familiar? I'm sure it should be gruesome there. You might want to bring a sword with or some such thing. Well, good luck, young Redden. Alright. Probably should have saved there, but let us cast a recall anchor right here. Yeah. And with that having been done, let's go. We are headed straight to the Stronghold of Copperston. Right, it's going to take us 2 days, and we have cast like a recall anchor, so we should be able to get back. We should have like 5 days to complete this quest. At least the place seems nice, although, I don't know about its denizens. Is my character completely unburdened is something that I'm wondering about. Yeah, let's just put all these in the cart, because we don't really need all of that. Here's to hoping that this dungeon is not the unreasonable kind. I mean, Unity, the skies and stuff in Unity can look nice, but I feel like the bloom sort of makes things appear a little worse than it did in the OG Vanilla Daggerfall. Ah, here we are. I was searching for the entrance. I mean, we can actually take any of these doors, we don't really necessarily need to take that one. But let's go all the way there anyway. Why is it so dark over there, my god. And there's like a post as well. And for the record, all of these doors will like actually spawn you into the same place, regardless of which doors you take. So, pre-dungeon save right here. Okay, so basically, there's only one way to go forward from the looks of it. Right, from the entrance, I mean. Alright, let's rest. Fortunately, we can rest, so let's rest. And the good thing about this dungeon is that we can't hear any skeletons. Oh, right. All the mummies would probably not be, you know. Let's try a little more rock. Right, spell of the field, we won't waste any more mana on that. There are bats and rats, which, I mean, they can be useful, but not exactly a thing that I'm looking for. So I'm guessing it's the other side that has, I can just fireball these guys. And yeah, train their destruction a little. Because why not? Let us go ahead and save here. Actually, let us go ahead and transfer some of the things that we picked up into the wagon. Anything, yeah, Golden Scarab and Holy Tome. Because we really don't need any of that. For the adventure anyway. Re-updating the save again. I thought I pressed the map button, but apparently I did not. Okay, so I was just checking for hidden tools, I did not see any back there. Here it is, the path deeper into the dungeon. I doubt that all this place has to offer are rats, but you never know. Could this... oh yeah. Let's, yeah. Did not have to heal there, but alright. It does possibly improve my restoration skill as well, so that's something, I suppose. Let us go ahead and, is there an door there? No. Let's drop a bead there to signify it as a place that we have to check out later. Should we ever return there? Now, I do not hear skeletons at all, so I sort of like this dungeon thus far. Yeah, let's just bash this door in. Right. Unlock spells are a little strange. They have a chance of success, which means a chance of success of successfully casting the spell, and nothing else really. It is not really a chance of unlocking the door. That is okay. We are talking about how there are no skeletons here, and we see one right off the bat. Hi. Die. Die. I guess our speed is high enough to where we can successfully parry the skeleton for the most part. Which is a good thing. Which is most definitely a good thing. Okay, so where are we headed next? Let us put a... excuse me. Yeah, thank you. Let us put a beat there for further exploration and just head on this way. And on that note, let us make a save here, because you can never be too careful in dungeons. I mean, everything's going smooth and then along comes a random... vampire ranged into ruin your day. Sometimes the quest objective can be behind a hidden door, like this one here. Not in this case apparently, but it can be there. Let us go ahead and update the previous save, because we did venture in a little further. And successfully checked out a quest location in that regard. I was checking for a hidden tool there, there are none. There's a rat there. So the thing that I like about level scaling Daggerfall is that every swing counts. Every swing counts, or every attempt at attacking something counts. It doesn't have to connect. It doesn't have to do any damage. Every single attempt will count. Typically. Especially when it comes to magic. The things like weapons, though, you do need to make sure that you are making contact. Like in this case, both of my spells did not make any sort of contact, so this rat was all fine. These seem interesting. Pre-interact. Let's save here. I doubt there are anything. Yeah, there's nothing. A holy dagger. So this part of the dungeon, are we missing some module back there? I do not believe so, no. So I guess we are headed all the way back up and we have this section to explore. This dungeon thus far seems pretty linear, but I have jinxed myself by saying that before, so I'm not going to make the same mistake again. I mean, having played Daggerfall all these days, I'm quite certain that this thing is going to open up into a vast labyrinthine structure anytime soon, so yeah. I've only been to one war thus far, but yeah, that does not make me a veteran of Daggerfall, or so I would like to believe. I see a skelly. Hi! How are you? Hi. This thing rocks. This thing definitely rocks. Okay, the game says I should meditate on what I've learned about destruction, but I'll do that later. For now, let us place a bead here, and a bead there, and let's head straight. I'm pretty certain that whatever, you know, there is in store for us, it's nothing that that's anything good, basically, is what I'm trying to say. Okay, let's check out that locked door first. I'm pretty sure I can't open this door because it's level 12 already, but let's try nonetheless. Spell effect field, let's try it again, because we have the magicka for it. Spell effect field. So that was a double waste of XP. Typically, first objectives can be behind these doors as well, but apparently it wasn't in this case. And we have yet another expansive structure to go ahead and explore. Casting invisibility again, and let us place a bead here. And explore the other side. This module seems familiar. I haven't explored a lot of this module, but it does indeed seem familiar. Very, very familiar, in fact. And just like that, this entire dungeon becomes just so much more expansive. So many similar looking places. Ah, just like a... Oh, wait. Oh no, it's one of those rooms. You know what? Let's go ahead and rest here for a while. Why not? I'm healed. I made a separate save here because typically these structures lead to like gargantuan labyrinths. So, yeah. I think this is going to lead into a pyramid of sorts, but who knows? I might be wrong. I know I've been wrong before, so yeah. Here we are, a door. And, yep, one of those structures there. The real Berencia part 9. I don't think that was a spicy one, but yeah, dungeon decorations. I'm surprised by the fact that there are no enemies here. There typically are supposed to be enemies around here. And also by the fact that I'm mostly finding rats and bats in this place. And nothing else really. I was quite certain that I probably would have found enemies that were more difficult. Ouch. Bring your butt here. Let me shock you. Alright, fine. Why aren't my spells hitting though? I feel like hitting rats with any kind of spell is quite difficult. Alright. Maybe a little more at a time, who knows. Of course, the spell effect failed. Why wouldn't it? What is this? Just mismatched textures, that's it, from the looks of it. We still have that little piece over there to explore, so... yeah, let's go ahead and save, keeping that in mind. The mismatched textures are really throwing me off, by the way. Making me feel like there is probably some sort of hidden door there. Good thing that I've got tooltips, which actually lets me know if there are any doors next to me or not. Okay, another one of those rooms. Sometimes there can be enemies inside here. And in those instances, I hear a skelly. Fuck you. Okay, that was easy. I guess my spell did like a whole bunch of damage to this guy. Let us close this door here. Yay! We have leveled up to level 4, which is impressive, to be honest. Intelligence, we could increase it, but for now, I think what I would like to probably increase are agility. And maybe speed? Willpower, let us increase willpower because it'll make our spell stronger. You have ascended to level 4. It's all suddenly obvious to you. You just have to concentrate all the energy and time you've wasted. It's a sin. But without the experience you've gained taking risks, taking responsibility for failure, how could you have understood? Indeed, nothing in life is a waste. It all contributes towards something. Let's save here. Looks like my character also rolled like a lot of health for this, 96. My health is like 96 now. So that's why you've got like such a huge pool of health still left. Wait a minute, my health actually regenerated. That's interesting. But the effect is like so negligible that it hardly matters. Looks like that's the end of the line for us, unless there are like some hidden tools or something over here. Typically these modules do not have hidden doors, but yeah, we just check just in case. Okay, so I guess we're going back down and checking out that side then. Wish I could just teleport, but that would ruin my previous recall anchor, so... Dungeons typically also have like special enemies, which are essentially enemies that you would want to avoid, typically. I thought that was one of those special enemies, but no, it's just this dangling woman here. I really do hope that I could like, just take her with me and rescue her, but apparently that is not how this game works. The game does not like it when you try and do something like that. It will not allow it, stand for it. Alright, back down there. I think somebody was talking about making a mod for it, but I do not really know whether that's whether they actually gotten to releasing it or not ever. Wait, this is 2 here, which we have not checked out yet. Alright, let's check it out. I wonder why we overlooked. Oh no! There's even like a teleporter skull there. Oh no! This dungeon crawl is going to be longer than I thought. Hold up. Just a minute. Let me. Wait, that's the dungeon exit. And. Yeah, let's just go ahead and open this door up. And please be down here. So that, yeah. I can mark it as a place to explore later. And for now, let's close this door. Save in the pre-interact slot. Sometimes after I save, it's like lighting in the game changes, but yeah, let's go. Wait. Does this do nothing then? Is this like just... Yeah, apparently it's not a teleporter. I was getting my panties all up in a bunch for no reason. It's just a regular skull floating in the sky for whatever reason. Not a teleporter at all. Unless I have to attack it somehow. Nope. Alright, picking that bead back up again. That I placed out there. Yeah, right here. This module is not a good module. Not at all. Aloha Mora. Of course it's Bellafield Field, but if not. I hear something objectionable back there, so I'm not exactly gonna try and explore it too much. Holy water and religious item. Surprisingly, I'm actually invisible to rats now. Which is like totally amazing, to be honest. I'm quite certain that my experience playing this game would have been significantly different had I not opted to go for spell regeneration in darkness. Actually, I did not opt to go for that. I more or less just have that because of a mod. I'm not supposed to have that. Spell regeneration in darkness, I mean. Yes, sometimes in these areas they can be vampire ancients. So it's better just essentially watch out, you know? Reflect about backstabbing. I didn't exactly want to be backstabber, but yeah. Here we are. We are going around backstabbing rats of all things. Saving again, because, well, that went well, so yeah. Whoops. I could just open this door, no need to bash it in. I think this is gonna lead into another dead end again, but you never know. I hear more rats. Oh, it's just a bat. I hear a skelly though. Hi. Successful backstab. Bat has died. Alright, there's nothing else here. Fine then. We are heading back. I can hear like skeletons on the other side of that room, but not the mummy that I'm looking for. My critical strike has also improved, although it is sort of a bad strategy to put it as a primary thing. Primary attribute, I mean. I hear more rats and bats. And I heard a door opening, but that's mostly just this place smells strongly of death. Ironically, that's probably because of all the death that I have left behind. Let us go ahead and update a save. Nox, sorry, Lumos. Nox makes it makes your light go out. That's not the spell that we're looking for. Okay, where are we headed again? Yeah, back towards, right, the place that we came out of. We have already cleared these areas, so pretty certain that we won't be walking into anything for the most part. There are instances when you can sometimes walk into, you know, enemies in these instances, but for the most part, we should not be walking into any of them. Right, so with that having been done, let us update a save here, this one. Right, and time to destroy this bead, because we are officially exploring this side as well. Okay, linear thus far. I heard something there, but I'm not quite certain what I heard. We press onwards. This is like another reason why I'm not... this is the one with the underwater section. Now here's the thing about mummies, the funny thing, right? They can be underwater as well. They can most definitely be underwater as well. Alright, so let us save here. Before we decide to take a loose dive. Good thing is, it'll let us test out our Aquas form spell. Which is like water breathing and water walking combined. That is most definitely not what I'm looking for, but is that nothing that I can pick up then? Do I dare tackle that thing? That looks like a moray eel. Or slaughter fish. I guess I can't really pick this up, or maybe I'm not in the at the correct level or something. Yeah, nah. More pieces of paper. Not... Okay, shit. That is the last thing that I wanted to see there, but oh well. Excuse me there. Right, so... I killed that thing just to add it to my bestiary, but... So where does this bring me? To a place that I've already been to. Which is... So I'm guessing this was supposed to take me back, but they never programmed it in. So let's load up that save that we made before this, previously, I mean. Yeah. The game made like a splashing sound because apparently the water splashed as we dove into it. Fine, I'll save some mana for other stuff. There's a bell, there's a vest and a religious item, but the vest is apparently enchanted, which is amazing. There are like all of these bottles here. I don't know for what purpose, but yeah, there are all of these bottles here. It's like... Waterwalking has like a different operating mechanism as compared to... Why can I not cast a spell on you? Am I not close enough to you then? Well, you sure took a chunk out of me there. Right, let's cast... I do really want to. Fine. How much harm can it do us, right? Not much at all. Alright, we're back out, and there's nothing here. We verified. What is this? That's like a vent of sorts. Interesting. I don't think I've ever seen that in Daggerfall, but then again, the textures have usually typically been so low poly that it's difficult to figure out whether what you're looking at is a vent or not. Okay, so where are we headed now? Straight over on that side. We have not yet covered that end, so might as well go ahead and cover it to the best of our abilities, I do believe. So it turns out that the... I do believe I showed you guys that, but... Why is it suddenly so dark here? Yeah? I can see a bat, but sidestab. Nothing here. Yeah, it's like the lighting of this game is inconsistent. Sometimes it's light, sometimes it's darker. You never know which one it is going to be next. Alright, we press on, like we always have. There are other parts of the dungeon that we are yet to explore, but this dungeon seems very kind to us, so at least thus far. So which way are we going again? One side of darkness or the other side is the question. Let us leave the upstairs for exploration and head this way. Especially because I believe I heard something there. Aqua's form is fading out. The durations of most of these spells are glitched. Okay, this place has nothing except for, you know, this little place. Lumos and invisibility were about to go out, so we recast them. I should probably, like, save again just to fix the lighting, but oh well. That's okay. There weren't any hidden doors back there, were there? Yeah, that was the room. No, that was not the room that we had just been to. It was rather this room. And no, from the looks of it, there were no hidden doors there. There typically aren't any hidden doors there, but you never know. Best to always check. When in doubt, check. Have you been there yet? Yeah, that is where we came from, so we definitely have been there. Where we need to go is that way. Right. This feels like a familiar module. Something that we've seen before and dealt with before. But apparently it's not, it's a different module. Oh, it's one of those expansive rooms with the enemies all around. Pretty certain that a War of Bethany, you hear very faint whispers. You know that this mod that lets these creepy things come in, that is really not a good mod. Makes this quickly turns this game into a horror game. Why am I so tall? Pretty sure the skeleton's gonna come out in time though. And that did nothing to fix the lighting. Let us wait for the frames to come back. And yeah, hit there. Right, so which way should we be going again? There's a rare symbol, a holy dagger, and a potion of cure disease. Let us drop something. Something we absolutely do not need, like this small statue right here. Let us drop this so that we can pick up the potion. And the holy dagger, and the rare symbol, because apparently the statue is fucking heavy. Okay, so there are two doors here that we can explore, and since I'm going towards that door, let us just place a bead there as a marker of a place that we're yet to explore. Okay, I'm just gonna place a bead there, a bead there, a bead there, and we're gonna go right. Oh shit, isn't this practically the same as... Elven shortbow, that will definitely sell for much. For money, I mean. Not for much. But yeah, for money. Let's go ahead and heal since we have the XP for it. The MP, the mana for it. But this is straight out of, I think, Vadest. The Dungeon of Vadest. It has like a similar structure to this. What the fuck did I get myself into? Why did I agree to this mission? Fine, let us go ahead and grind. We're gonna try as much as we can, but at any point in time, once we are tired. Yeah. I'll just leave your poison there. And you can do what you want to. In your own time. Nothing here, right? Right, it's gonna connect that bridge over there. That thing is gonna be like this detour of sorts. Once I get tired though, I'm just gonna probably gonna go to quest marker and get this done with. There was some infighting recently. The way you can tell is because a giant bat died without reason. I can hardly see shit. Like, this is problem with Daggerfall Unity. Sometimes you can hardly see shit. It's a very common problem. Here we are, this is probably gonna come out at... I like the way that the bat was casting shadows. Because of the light of this torch. Yeah, there's nothing there. We'll cover it all slowly. We will cover it all slowly. Huge ass dungeons, seriously. Hi. Hi. Perhaps it is time to reflect on what you've learned about Blunt Weapon. Now, let's keep this as a side and go explore that side. Because sometimes, as you climb up higher along this side, there tend to be hidden doors on the walls which might have quest objectives behind them in this particular dungeon module. Right. I still think about pressing and holding down the B button the same way it was in, you know, vanilla Daggerfall. But yeah, we all know it doesn't work that way. Not in this game, at least. Right then. That is, I believe, where I went in. Yes, that was. So then, I do believe I missed a hidden door there, right there. So yeah, that's pretty much what I wanted to see. Where is the goddamn hidden door? And we'll go right back to it. And yeah, it should be somewhere right here. These doors might have what you're looking for. Let me just go ahead and save. And the game turned even darker. Why? Why, game, do you hate me perchance? Yes, sometimes the quest objectives can be hidden away here. I see something's trying to break through. I'm just gonna let them. And hopefully... Sounds like a skelly. How did that feel, son? Okay, that was the other skelly that I had previously injured, apparently. But where's the goddamn mummy that I'm looking for? Holy dagger and the rear symbol, which we cannot pick up, because obviously why would we be able to? Now, question is, do we want to go back there and check out the one place that we have not checked out yet? I believe that is in order. We should do that before we decide to explore this castle any further. Right then. Here we go. Exploring the dungeon. The depths of this dungeon. Let's save. Always better to keep saving Daggerfall. You never know when it's going to be useful. Okay, which way are we headed now? Good question. Have you been there before? Another good question. I know not. Apparently we have not. So let us take the road on the right and we'll check out the road on the left later. I heard a door opening, but I don't know if it was part of the background music or the actual game itself. It would be a little awkward if it was part of the game. That was pretty powerful spell, if I say so myself. Why are my spells becoming so much more powerful? Is it because I increased my willpower? Holy shit, that makes such a huge difference, I wonder. Like, why? How? Anyway, yeah, let's update the save again. Right, so the game actually... crashed. And we'll be getting off again. From where, I do not know yet, but I feel like I should have an idea soon enough. Let us kill this bat. If I have Mr. Tour here, might as well go and explore it then. Aloha Mora. Spellific Field, of course. And, yeah, we should probably put a bead down here. Yeah, so this is where I left off the last time around, I feel like. Yes, in fact it is. It is the place that I left off last time around. And I was about to go and, you know, search the place up there. Like a place down here, essentially. One of this hidden door right here, which I had failed to explore previously for whatever reason. So yeah, that's what we're about to do now. So I don't believe this is the way, but I don't recall seeing this club right here. Because this is the wrong way. This is not the way that we want to go. We want to go right here. We will come back and address you later. But for now, we are headed this way. And at least one good thing that happened is that the game crashing sort of made the lighting better. It fixed the lighting, so I'm definitely thankful for that. I hear some stuff, like a ghost. Maybe it's a mummy as well that I can hear. I'm not certain at this point, but yeah. So that is not the place that I'm looking for. I'm looking to take a left at the next door, take a right, and then, yeah. We should find the place that we're searching for after right after this bend. Yeah, right here. A double locked door of all things. Let us save here, since we took all that effort on to come here. Well, I don't see anything here. This is where the track comes out. The track that we had avoided initially. Aloha Mora, maybe? Yeah, Aloha Mora. Of course the spell failed. Why would it not? I hear something back there. And that's pretty much the entire reason that I'm not exactly going in there yet. But let me just go ahead and give this room a quick glance, make sure that there's nothing in here that that is left to explore. Yeah, we have completely explored this section. Let us go back to the place we left off and continue exploring this end first. Let me quickly go ahead and remove all these markers, because that is a dead end. This, we have already explored this end. This one side here that we yet explored, this side as well, and then there's that side there, which we definitely do wish to explore. And yeah, apparently we have explored that part as well. I don't know why I've decided to put a marker on it or a bead on it, but from the looks of it, we have pretty much explored this part of the map as well. So I doubt it would hurt to remove this marker, because it essentially just leads us back here. We have already explored it in its entirety. Alright then, we head back out, and yeah, that's the way we came in. We have explored the other side as well, I think. Yes, we have. Yes, sirree. Alright. Let's head back. And we can now head upstairs. I think this was the place that we needed to go. I mean, there is that one place over there that we yet to explore. And we can go there by heading straight. You know what, while we're here, let's just go and explore that side then. And do I take a right here? I wonder. Yes, I can actually take a right there. I definitely can hang a right there. In fact, I should hang a right there. And then we take a left from the T-junction up ahead. I heard a door opening, but I'm not certain whether it was a part of the background music or a part of... somebody actually opening the door. Rats are notoriously difficult to hit, aren't they? Aloe. And a bell. I hear something. Maybe we're close to the objective. Okay, aloe mora. Of course, spell of appeal. Let's try that again. Why can I never cast it? The spell. I mean, it does have a pretty low chance of being cast. Alright, so while these spells are going out, let us go ahead and rest. A lot of skills improved. My apologies for that. You probably heard me cough. I tried to mute those parts, but I wasn't quick enough this time. And I should now rest on what I've learned about illusion, because apparently I have learned something about illusion. Okay, so this area has also been explored now. So I suppose it's safer to go ahead and destroy this marker. Now then, which other areas of this map are left, I wonder? I'll just put a thing there, a bead there, and yeah. Let's go back upstairs, and we'll check out the area with the ascender on the right. Is this the way? I mean, that is definitely the way to go upstairs, but we have to go all the way around and check it out first. You never know where the first objective might be in the game. It's like they're hidden away in every single nook and cranny that you can think of. I hear something around here. I could just levitate up there, but yeah, let's just stick to the more traditional route for now. And I do believe this is where we are supposed to go. Excuse me. Yep, it is. Saving again, because I made it all the way here. I hear skellies. Hi. Okay, this spell is definitely very, very powerful now. The fireball spell, I mean. Yep. As expected, this takes us all the way to the top. There's like something hovering. Oh, maybe the loot pile that was supposed to be there initially. Hmm. We can probably levitate over to it, but I'm pretty sure that we need to kill a mummy for our quest to work. This guy's dead. There's the mummy. Hi. I've been searching for you. 231 gold pieces and mummy wrappings, but we need to drop something to pick it up first. Yes, what do we drop then? We got lots of stuff. These are only half kg. Maybe, nah. Icon is a kilogram. Let's remove the talismans. We could probably remove the icons as well. We got lots of stuff here. But first, all the gold and then the mummy wrappings. But these are the mummy wrappings that we were looking for, right? I wonder. Yeah, magical items. Look at this. Ingredients. Should be... Yep, ingredients. Mummy wrappings. These are, in fact, the quest items. You know because they are... They have a green background, the way quest items typically do. So with that being said, we do not know what these are. I cannot cast Identify for whatever reason. I do not have enough... Wait, I do. You know what, let me just save first. Yeah, let's use the slot here. Good thing I found the mummy. Okay, Divine Insight. Wait, I can only select one? Oh, I can select all three. One out of three identified. Which one was it? That was... Unknown. Unknown. This one then. Vest of the Orc Lord. Orc Strength. Interesting. Can I not like select and identify them again? Of course, I do not have enough spell points left. That was a pretty good use of the identify spell, I feel like. Let us wait a while. Camp here while our magicka returns to us. So that we can just directly teleport back to the quest giver. So how you guys been in the recent past? I think that should be enough. Teleport. For a moment there I thought maybe the game was not going to load, but apparently it did. So one of the commenters told me I actually didn't take permission from them to use the name, so I'm not going to use it. But one of the commenters told me that all of these walls and rendering glitches is probably occurring because of the fact that I'm using a mod which lets me see out of windows, the transparent windows mod essentially. So yeah, let's go ahead and talk to this guy though. So maybe look out for it if you're going to use teleport inside buildings. Well, teleport to locations within buildings. And that's what I wanted to say, yeah. Okay. Now that is a lovely piece of wrapping. Thanks awfully. I believe we agreed on 183 gold pieces, yes? Yes indeed. Okay, so let us go ahead and get some of these other things identified. Where is the identifier then? We are at a safe place now. So this woman could be right here. Okay, let us and identify these. I mean, it's so cheap to just identify things yourself. Okay. Wand of Fortitude. Cast when held, Fortitude. And that's literally all it does. Never tiring priest robes. Anyway. Let's go ahead and bring out a wagon and remove some of the stuff that we've got. And mostly these things, you know, which are taking up quite a bit of space in their inventory. Talisman, Real Valencia, part 9. I'm quite certain that by the time I actually take on the quest to suppress the copies of the Real Valencia, I might actually have all of the parts myself. So what was this again? Peace robes of stamina, never tiring peace robes. Right. Vest of the Orc Lord, Orc Strength. Let's just keep that back where it belongs. And let's put this, put these in the inventory as well. And here you are, sir. Let us go ahead and save the game in the pre-quest slot. And let us talk to this guy. Get another quest from him. As the premier research institution in the Empire of Tamriel, the Mage's Guild employs a number of mystics and scholars all over the land. If we can get a representative of the guild over to a place within a reasonable distance of here, the eminent scholar Mordor Gerard has agreed to share his research. Would you be available for this? I didn't catch the assignment. What is it? If we can get a representative of the guild over to a place within a reasonable distance. Okay, so I'm apparently supposed to contact Mordor Gerhardt, and I'm guessing it's inside of a dungeon. Sure. Grand, just grand. Apparently not. Now, Mordor Gerhardt is staying in the Bat and the Fairy Pub in a place called the Moorwing Residence for just a few days. The dangers of necromancers, those reprobate spell singers, are interested in getting to Mordor Gerhardt and his research. It will give you 12 days to get... I will give you 12 days to get to Mordor Gerhardt and back before I send someone else. Good luck. Bat in the Fairy Pub in the Moorwing Residence. Right, I'm guessing that place would probably have like only one residence. But I doubt it'll stick. I don't think it'll stick, so let's just go out. The frames have come back. Now, this is the beautiful part of, look at all those stars. My god, I should come out at the night more often. Especially since I've got powers in the night. Whew. And look at this place. It's so, like, it's got this, everything's got this shiny halo around it. It looks so brilliant. But, where are we supposed to hit again? Right. Research notes. Bat and Fairy Pub. Now, question is why? Wait, 12 hours? Or 15 hours? 15 hours apparently. Okay. Okay, Bat and Fairy Pub. Let us. Wait, is that place inside here? Or where is it? So another thing about staying out here during the night is the fact that because this is not the province of Daggerfall, or Daggerfall City to be exact, we won't get attacked by any ghosts. We might get attacked by random thieves and stuff, but not ghosts. That is for certain. Okay, so Bat and Fairy Pub. It says Bat and Fairy Pub. So I guess we're on the road to search for it. But it... I don't think it's here. That's a queen's wolf. I don't think... Why are you out here all alone in the middle of the night, love? It's literally past 9:30. Let's just confirm once. I don't think the Bat and Fairy Pub is here. Restless Wolf, Beaver and Cat, Rat and Pit, Dead Hedgehog, Bat and Jerk. No Bat and Fairy Pub here. Right. There are even dogs around here. Interesting. The Devil's Dragon, the Queen's Wolf. Let us look for the Bat and Fairy Pub. I didn't need to type it all out like that. Yes, here we are. Now, here's the thing. It takes 3 days to travel there. How am I gonna do it in like that limited amount of time then? You're entering the Bat and Fairy Pub. A young lad with fierce eyes hands you a letter and runs away into the alleys. Interesting. So I guess this is where the timer was. Yes, exactly. It was probably because we had to reach him within that time limit. Otherwise, the necromancers would have abducted the poor soul. I see that. That's how it goes. Letter TB. That's it. Let's read it. Strange blood. do not make an enemy of the Dark Brotherhood. We can be of great help to one another, but you could not wish for a worse enemy. When you have Mordor Gearhart's research paper, bring it to me here at the Hearthouse residence in Illison Hills. Fail not, or the wrath of Mephala, Queen of Oblivion, be on you. Lysoria Woodsley, eh? Let's ask a few people about this Lysoria Woodsley character. Tell me about... people, right here. Oops. I do not exactly have an option to ask about Lysoria Woodsley. There is people. Nope. Whoops. Yeah, let's just ask you about location people. General moving residence. No, I don't have a clue. Pretty sure you're not gonna tell me either. I mean, that woman did not have a clue, but I guess that's east of where we're standing. How did you actually go ahead and tell me about it, I wonder? Because typically you're not supposed to. Like, these guys are supposed to be telling me about all this stuff. This is it, the moving residence. Seems like a pretty straightforward delivery job, but I'm pretty sure it can get fucked up in a hurry. And yeah, that's why you play Daggerfall, for the plot twists, to be honest. No other reason to play it at all. The bat and the djinn. You hear, welcome! Well, I can rest, so I'm guessing there are no enemies near me. I do not have the spell points for that. Are you the person that I'm looking for? Mordor Gearhart, nope. I do, there you are. So Mordor Gearhart was also a person who was somebody that I was investigating as a warrior. You're the Breton, the Mage Skill Center would predict my book, yes. Marvelous to meet you, my child. Here's the bally thing. Good luck getting past those infernal necromancers with it. I certainly couldn't. Right then. So, should we just stick around here a while and... Actually, it does not really matter, does it? Just in case there's somebody outside, you know? Alright. So, we're pulling out a cart and we are traveling back to Illiac Hills. And what I'm certain this is going to do is... Probably should have cast a recall anchor there, but oh well. I like the lush greenery in this game. Anyway, so what this is going to do, what my actions are going to probably do, is the fact that it's gonna send some assassins from the Dark Brotherhood after me from now on, at regular intervals of the game. Well, I guess you were the woman that I saw last night, weren't you? Interesting. And I do believe that is the major skill over there. Yes, it is. Yes, indeed it is. Now, what did the letter say again? I received a threatening letter from Lysoria Woodsley of the Dark Brotherhood telling me to bring Mordor Gearhart's research paper to the Hearthouse residence in Illiac Hills instead of the major skill. So right now, up until this point, we have had a choice of what to do. Alright. Let us go and submit the research into the major skill because... What's the time right now? It's 10 o'clock. Should be unlocked in like 2 minutes. Game time, which is like 10 seconds real time. Look at this guy. Such a beauty. I was commenting about this before, but the recording in that part of the game got somehow ruined, so I had to skip it over. But yeah. This game does add like a whole lot of effects. Like if I was to turn the palatization off, yeah. Look at how pretty it looks now. Just look at it. This is what the game looks like. Oh my god, this thing is shining? Probably because of the color boost as well. And I can see in the shadows. Okay, so it was actually my bad then, probably. The fact that... Yeah, but then again, if I turn off color boost right now, everything's gonna go back to being dull. At least I can still see down there. But yeah, the world does seem a little dull, especially for a day that's like super bright. I'm healthy. It's not telling me the weather, though, which is something that Arena used to do. I love that feature. The more I think about Arena, the more I fall in love with it. I don't know why, but I just love that game. More so than Daggerfall, actually. yeah, let's turn these effects back on and enable. And just take a look at that difference. Boost process, palletization. And this is what the game looks like. Oh, yeah, right. So this is what the game looks like originally without any of that crap. Just to show you guys, it's definitely past time. It's 11:11 right now. We have overshot the time limit, but my god, does it look beautiful. Holy hell. I've been missing out on all of this. I don't know, I mean, if I feel like it, I might change the settings later on, but yeah, for now, let us turn that on, and yeah, we're gonna... That looks super crappy. I mean, for whatever reason, I don't know why, but it makes the game look crappier than it looked when I played it in the DOS version. And this is like the closest we can get to like the original feel of it, or rather like a very bastardized kind of feel of it. But at any rate, here we are. Let's head into the Mage's Guild and hand over the research. Here's to hoping that the spies that we encounter further will not kill us. But at this point, I would just like to make a save, which I will not be touching, and we'll make it. We'll name it Rollback. We'll name it Rollback in case the spies that we encounter end up being the kind that we cannot take on safely. So let's hand over the research. Oh, this is brilliant stuff. I guess those damned necromancers were not too difficult to handle, at least not for you. Spiffing job, apprentice. I feel like we've done this before, but the last time around we were quick enough to the point where we never received that letter from the necromancers. Alright, so let us take his gold then, and then save the game here, pre-quest. So reputation should be at, 12 right now. With the Mage skill, that should make us eligible for a promotion. So... Primary skill... I do believe like if we are to take like a high skill and a low skill, we should come out on top, depending like especially considering all the skills that the Mage skill focuses on. So yeah, I do believe that we are quite well on our way to a promotion right now. So we'll talk to him. If he does not promote us, then we'll see what to do next. By order of the Archmagister of the Illiac Bay and the Council of the Mages Guild of the Elysian Hills, Strangeblood the Breton is henceforth promoted to the rank and title of Journeyman. Your devotion and prowess is thus noted. Strive ever forward. I am humbled by this promotion. Thank you. I strive to seek the Mages Guild better. And with that, we have officially accomplished... Sorry, I don't know whether you caught that or not, but with that we have officially accomplished what we set out to accomplish with this playthrough. We have... In fact, you know what, let me just go ahead and turn this off. I feel like I'm missing out on a lot. Whoops, not that. Yeah, let's just turn it off entirely because this game looks so pretty without any of that extra stuff. Yeah, I'll keep this on because otherwise things seem a little too gloomy, but yeah. Wow, that makes like a huge world of difference. A huge world of difference. My god, that looks so much better. Whew. But yeah, like I was saying, that brings us to the end of this playthrough. This was pretty much the entire reason that we started playing today, essentially, to get a promotion in the Mage's Guild. And luckily for us, the second quest was quite simple and not difficult. Although we did get offered a choice, which probably will come back to bite us in the ass later on. But Strangebird being Strangebird is not going to back down to threats. And with that being said, thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. When we get back, we will be probably be trying to get promoted in one of the temples. In fact, let's go ahead and check out the temple. Maybe we are eligible for a promotion, or maybe a month has in fact passed. 16th of mid-year. Let's try, you never know. Let's go ahead and get promoted in the Mage's Guild as well. I have seemingly found like a few stores where I can sell some of the stuff that I gathered, including the Bank of Elysian Hills. I'm just gonna identify all of these pieces. And first class weaponsmith. The Crimson Chasm. Okay, so where are we headed? I think that is the place that we want to go. That is the castle. Yeah, the Order of Arcay should be north and slightly east, so that way. Mostly north, but slightly east. Between north and northeast for the most part. Yes, right here. Let us go ahead and see if we can get upgraded. You're still there. I'm so sorry I took you out of your home. I wish there was a way that I could put you back in your I would like to say place, but I mean home. But unfortunately, there isn't. So, well, yeah. At least it's good to see that you're zealous though. Strange bug. Let us go and talk to him. Yeah, we still haven't got the promotion for the temple yet, even though we are eligible for it. I checked the requirements for the attributes as well, and we are eligible. So I guess we'll need to. The next time we come back, we'll grind up in the Temple of Arcay until we can get promoted here as well. So until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.